shows Abraham Lincoln in my presentation. That picture shows Abraham Lincoln at a battlefield in 1867 or something. Sorry, around that time, but I'm a bit. But he was the last president to actually visit an active battlefield. And while he was there, he actually came under fire from Confederate gunfire. And Colonel Wendell Holmes barked, apparently, legend has it, barked at him to get down before and threw him to the floor. So, yeah. Why did I choose this person? Abraham Lincoln is the infamous of being a significant assassination. He was the 16th president of the United States. He's obviously a very important figure to America's history. It can be said that he is the most important president ever. I think it's fair to say that almost anyone with knowledge of America has probably heard of Abraham Lincoln. My initial impression of Lincoln was a good one, having read a book in which I learned that his way, how he worked his way up to his career. I also knew about the fact that he was for equal rights during the American Civil War for black people. I consider Abe to be a much known figure. Abraham Lincoln was responsible for keeping the United States united. His war effort meant that the Republic did not overthrow government and become an anarchy. Above his monument lies a quote saying, "In this temple, as our hearts of the people for whom he saved the Union, the memory of Abraham Lincoln is enshrined forever." This emphasizes his importance to the nation. So there's some fun facts. Abe is a descendant of Samuel Lincoln, who migrated from Norfolk, England, in 1638. Abe grew up on a farm in Indiana where his family owned 88 acres of land. This area was free and did not contain slavery. As a youth, Abe disliked the hard labor associated with the frontier life of farming. He was often called lazy and could be caught food in writing or creating poems. In his late teens, Abe became more distant with his father due to his father's education. In 1813, he acquired a job from a merchant in which he delivered goods by boat from New Salem to New Orleans. When he got to New Orleans, Abe witnessed firsthand the tragedy of slavery. This was the start of Abe's political. This is the start of when he started to hate slavery. Abe's first political role was in Illinois House of Representatives, where he expressed views against slavery, saying the institution of slavery is founded on both a bad injustice and bad policy. After a hasty career in politics, having failed to be re-elected, Abe returned to practicing law in Springfield for 16 years. Lincoln's reputation with his clients gave way to earning the nickname Honest Abe. In 1854, his party, the Whigs Party, began to fall apart and Abe joined the new Republican Party, largely formed in opposition to the extension of slavery in new US territories. On the 16th of 1958, Lincoln made his famous House Divided speech. That's a quote from anywhere. This speech was very significant in politics. It illustrated the fact that a house could not survive half free and half slave. On the 6th of November 1960, Lincoln became the 16th president of the United States, representing the Republican Party. On the 9th of April 1865, the Union was defeated, and the Confederate state and Lincoln's war effort became a success after 620,000 American deaths. Abe was assassinated at the age of 54 in 1965, 5 days after the official win of the Union. John Wilkes Booth, a famous actor and Confederate sympathizer, fatally shot and President Lincoln at the Playfield Theatre in Washington, D.C. On that night there was actually a series of attacks on other government ministers and stuff, people in government. They mainly failed. What changes to bring, say, we can. Lincoln's quote, those who deny freedoms others deserve it, not themselves, and under just go cannot non-retain it. As the map shows, Lincoln faced tough competition from other parties. His victory was entirely due to the strength of the North and the West. No ballots were cast for him in 10 of the 15 Southern state and slave states, and he won only 996 counties in the Southern state. Only two of the 996 counties in the Southern states. So throughout his career, he was in strong competition with someone called Douglas, who represented for much of the Civil War, Lincoln was forced to serve as both Commander-in-Chief and Commander of Staff. This was because when the Civil War began, the USA had no organization of high command suited to the vast size of the war operation. Lincoln supplied a good deal of strategic thinking for the nation's armies, despite his lack of technical military knowledge. Lincoln made mistakes, including early on in the ability to pick the right man to head the armies. Lincoln had fought in the Black Hawk War, which was a brief war in 1832 against Native Americans. However, this took a little preparing for the advanced step up. So that shows Lincoln defend. He was protecting a Native American from his own troops there. So again, it shows like compassionism. Lincoln's main opposition for Bright's career was clearly the Confederation. The path of the nation split against his views, aiming to break the Union and in favor of expansion on slavery. Before Lincoln's presidency, there was a series of famous debates over slavery between Lincoln and Democrats, Stephen and Douglas. These debates have even been referred to as the most famous political debates in American history. I believe that Lincoln's contribution is an international one, not just a national one. Lincoln's Emancipation Proclamation, issued in 1863, freed all slaves in the rebellious states and paved the way for slavery, slavery's eventual abolition. Slavery is a significant activity to destroy. I believe this one. Best accomplishments ever achieved by the US President. Lincoln was also able to save the Union. Lincoln was also responsible for some of the most famous quotes in American history. Those are some of the possible flaws, such failures that there were 620,000 people killed in battle during the Civil War. That's the most ever killed in any of their wars. I mean, they lost less people in World War II, like in the second highest. And Lincoln actually violated some of the civil liberties to further his war effort after some like rebels in his countries. He allowed people to speak without trial. And is he everything you believe? part of the speech, if you read that, was made by Lincoln in a series of debates between Lincoln and Douglas. This personally affects my thoughts on Lincoln. I'm still very grateful for what he achieved, however, I understand that he believed in the founding father's phrase, all men are equal. This part of his speech does not suggest that. How should you be remembered? The United States remains united. Slavery has been abolished in America. Lincoln paved the way for equality in America. In a time where it could have been easy for Lincoln to sit back in the crowd and the front bridge of the trade, Lincoln took a stand. He gave his life.